Hello, kittens, and welcome to the third annual IMPYS Pre-Show. Woo, with me, Kitty Powers. Don't all get too excited. Now, today, as usual, we're going to be chatting to some of the lovely molecules from Media Molecule, obviously the creators of dreams. We're going to be finding out what kind of dreams they like, what sort of thing they look for, and also we'll be hearing some special messages. Now, tonight, some very talented creators are going to be vying to win one of these. No, not one of these. This is the stunt Impy. One of these. Ooh, look at that. One of these fabulous Impy trophies. Now, obviously, everyone's a winner that gets into this award ceremony, but only a few of them will be getting to take one of these home. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. Hello, kittens. Now I'm here with my first guest, the lovely Abby from Media Molecule.
Hi, it's great to be here.
Now, as you know, Abby's heavily involved in the IMPYS every year, amongst other things. Now tell us a little bit about the IMPYS.
Well, this year we decided to do something that was a little bit different, and we have made an in-game hub that showcases the best of collaboration and a lot of the community projects that we think are really special. So the team has been working almost kind of making a response to community content. So it's really fun. It's sort of an interactive art gallery. There's a lot of hidden bits.
We're sitting in right now.
What?
The magic of technology.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
Isn't it just?
Yeah, this is amazing.
So yes.
Yeah, so you can go and check it out in-game right now. There's like tons of hidden cool little bits, and you can find impies that were made by members of the team with little messages on them. It's really fun.
There's one that looks a bit like me.
There is.
There's other lots of Easter eggs, isn't there?
There sure are.
So go look for them now, because it will add a whole new dimension to the Impy Awards. Now, tell us, have you got any top tips for dreams that you've discovered this year?
Well, you know, I'm a big fan of, I've always been like a big proponent of the interactive, like art gallery kind of space. I mean, the hub this year is a great example of that. So the Idyllium really stood out for me, really one of my favorite creations. But I really like the weird stuff, they're like Jankbot and Wibble Wobble and these cool like fun games that you can play on stream and get like a high score and that are just ridiculous and really could only exist in dreams. And I find that stuff really compelling. And then there's some amazing music videos and collaborations like Please Stand By, where, you know, it wasn't made as one thing. It was like a response, the video is sort of a response to hearing the song. And like, I love that kind of stuff. There's so many good stories and so many cool things to check out and things that I don't know where I would find things like that if it wasn't for dreams.
Have you got any final fabulous words of wisdom before we get into the main thing?
This is such a nice time of the year, and not because, you know, we're you know, awarding specific things. It's just like it's a good time for us as a team to play things together and talk about them and sort of catch up on dreams and the community. And it's just a really nice event that brings the studio together. And I love being able to hear from everyone on the team what they're playing, what interests them, and all that kind of stuff. So I think it's just a huge thank you to the dreams community for all the ways that you inspire us constantly.
And we're here with our first group of lovely molecules. We've got the wonderful Rich T, we've got Andy, and we've got the lovely Zach as well. Now, why don't you tell us, one by one, in an orderly fashion, what were the dreams that stood out to you this year?
For me, quite a few things stood out. I really enjoyed the creations that really capitalized on like the aesthetics of dreams. So like the scenes by SSG, T Soul E, Shandy Boy, 1975, and obviously the text gadget scenes by Todu. all the kits that people have been making, you know, for like the FPS creation kit by Intra Attack Out and the platformer kit by Mitamac, and also lots of the things that people have been making that enable people to extend their creations, like Wibble Wobble by Entropy Tamed. And obviously a shout out to Dreamsfest as well, which was amazing.
Well, you've done your homework, Andy. What about you, Rich?
I really enjoyed Idyllium, the kind of museum art center place. It was awesome. I really enjoyed that one. Some of the other favorites were Commonote. I wasn't quite sure how to pronounce that one, but that was awesome as well. And Impressionable, I really liked the gameplay of that. You had to kind of split up the word to make different things. That was really good fun. So they were probably my top three. Also, as anything by Ice Cream Cheese, who did Grub Night and has done some crazy stuff with like the plane and a moving toilet that spits stuff at you. And yeah.
If you check out the hub, the IMPYS hub, you might find a little dedication to the idiom. What about you, Zach?
Four words, open world boxing game. which is, it was funny, it was sexy. I'm not sure if it was supposed to be sexy. It definitely was sexy going into the boxing gym. I don't like boxing, it's awful, but it made boxing seem actually quite cool as well. Like, I just thought it was, and the cuts, the camera work was amazing. So, open world boxing game. You might disagree, Kitty, but I like it when people do a lot with a little. And I thought Commonote had such a great game loop, and done in such like an economical way. So those are the highlights for me.
Fabulous. Now tell me, when you're on the Dreamiverse looking for stuff to play, what sort of thing do you look for? What are your favourite genres and things?
For me, I really like bite-sized creations that like to do things a little bit differently, because obviously Dreams is like this very open platform with lots of weird and wonderful things, and I really like to find those niche hidden gem type items that you wouldn't find anywhere else. So yeah, thank you to all the people making those kind of things.
Yeah, similar. I guess I like being surprised. I do like the odd horror game, and yeah, those kind of, as Andy said, the kind of weird and wacky stuff that you just wouldn't find anywhere else is just incredible. And strategy games. So strategy and horror are probably my favourite genres. So keep making those, please.
On to my final question. Have you got a message for all the dreamers out there in the Dreamiverse?
Yeah, I absolutely. I guess, firstly, I want to say to all the creators and curators and players, thank you for everything you do, and keep doing what you do, because you help make the Dreamiverse an incredibly special place. And for those that are interested in dabbling in creation, I strongly recommend you check out the new templates. And if you have a pair of moves, strongly recommend Kareem's masterclass, because when I went into that, I just opened up a whole can of creativity that I didn't know was inside. So yeah, give that a go.
So being an analyst and looking through a lot of the data, there's a few, Zach and I are probably chuckling, there's a few tips that I think we're going to be putting together for creators to kind of maximize the visibility and the kind of playtime of their games. One of them that will probably be on there is don't have a huge cutscene at the start of your dream. People tend to drop out if you have a massive long cutscene. But yeah, all joking aside, you know, it's been a fantastic year for Dreams. There's been some fantastic creations, so just keep at it.
Thank you for your time, my darlings, and enjoy the show after this pre-show.
Thanks, you.
Thanks, Kitty. Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. And now it's time to chat to our next lovely group of molecules, and it's some of our community team. Hello, kittens. We've got Rhys, Jacob, Ali, and Holly.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey.
My first question is, and it's probably quite an obvious one, is what dreams have stood out to you this year on the Dreamverse? And let's start with Rhys.
I think for me, Wargarble has really shown that he is such an iconic style. And the creation for me in particular is the Golden Age of Madness, which is his very, very first game that he sort of released. And it is a fantastic little platformer kind of game. It's really fantastic.
What about you, Jacob?
One I enjoyed really recently was Penjara from Rainholder. It was like their debut game. I love puzzle games in the style of like Myst, and it really delivers on this, like, creating this amazing mysterious world you can walk around and explore, and the puzzles are absolutely like tough as nails. Like, they are rough, but if you are a fan of hard puzzles, it is an absolute dream come true. One that I know that Ali and I specifically loved early in the year was like Into the Night from Sergeant Hamster. Like, that was a gorgeous adventure game with a beautiful open world. And the story behind that game, like Sergeant Hamster developing it with their child, is so lovely. And it's really great to see that character and adventure continue. And another game that I also really loved was An Ordinary Death from Method Actor, which was a jam entry from earlier in the year, last year, which was like a really intriguing combination between text adventure and sort of a black comedy horror game. Really amazing writing there, and I know Method Actor was like really proud of that one. I think they should be, because it was a fantastic narrative experience.
One that's really stood out and stuck with me is Fragments for the Autistica Jam. That's kind of got a special place in my heart because it was one of the very first dreams that I started playing when I joined MM. And so it's kind of like, I've kind of like associated that with my starting time. But also like when I played it, I was like, wow, this has set a really high bar for like what's to come for my journey here.
Fab. What about you, Ali? The OG curator.
Well, yeah, thank you very much. Just like Jacob, I mean, I sort of feel the pressure to mention everything because honestly, so much stuff is incredible. I mean, what impresses me are all the dreams that like almost make me forget that I'm even playing dreams. So there's things like Slice from Man Chicken Turtle, which is an incredible like 2D action arcade game, and Flow World from Venwave, Frequency from Trix9, which is like an experimental visual novel, the likes of which you just probably wouldn't get outside of dreams. Frozen Frenzy from Ruri Dan is an absolute high score classic. And then there's even Pressure Chapter 1, which is like a first person horror game up there with anything that, you know, is out there in the past few years. And it's all made in dreams. It's amazing.
When you're searching the Dreamiverse for something to play, what sort of thing do you look for, or what places do you look? Because there's many tools for finding things in the Dreamiverse, like different pages and stuff. Which one's your favourites?
Yeah, so I would like to first like shout out to like the curation team first of all, because like every Monday they will just come up with a playlist and a set, just a collection full of so many things I would have probably missed if it weren't for them. So first of all, yeah, shout out to you guys. But second of all, when I'm like making content in general, I'm like searching throughout the Dreamiverse to find what would fit in with the latest meme that I'm about to make or something. And a lot of the stuff that I do make are very weird and specific. So I could just literally go into the search engine and be like burrito, and there'll be like so many, like hundreds of like creations that I can just play through and then put that into like a TikTok, for example.
Have you got a special message or something you want to tell the Dreamiverse or the Dreamers for this year?
For me, dreams really, really excels when there's simple ideas, big executions, you know. And we see that all the time in dreams, you know. We see it all the time where people have these very quirky little ideas, and they're able to execute them fantastically. So for me, start small and just work your way up. And eventually you'll get to a part where you're like, I can create anything.
I think for me, my message would be just don't be afraid to be yourself and be different, be strange, express. Like, even if you think you have the weirdest idea in your head that no one's going to understand, just go for it, do it. Because I think the magic of dreams is that everyone is interested in what you have to say. And that, like, that is the brilliant thing with the community that I've loved getting to know them over the past year. I think just keep being awesome, keep being strange and weird. And just don't be afraid to put your ideas into the game and just let them just unleash them onto the world.
I would say that every week, I guess you can see, you see a lot of like really experienced dreamers out there, and their work can be very, very polished and really big and on such a large scale that you might find it kind of daunting almost, I guess. But don't be kind of put off by that and just go in with, because sometimes you might think that, oh, I need to make it really, really polished for anyone to notice it. That's not the case. We notice a lot of different kind of creations from a wide spectrum. If you have an idea, just go for it. And also, don't be afraid to ask for help, because the community are so helpful. Like, if you need help with people just playtesting or like voice acting or anything like that, just don't be afraid to ask for help. People love to help here. The community are great.
What about you, Ali?
Just keep on like supporting each other. Ultimately, it's a privilege for us to be able to like shine a spotlight on you all. And if you just keep it going, that's incredible. Keep shining and supporting each other. That's just all it is.
It's been lovely seeing you all. Enjoy the Impies, which is coming up after this. And thank you all for dressing up, making an effort.
Thanks for having us.
See ya. Bye.
Bye.
See ya.
Joining me now is the wonderful Kareem Atuni, the art director here at Media Molecule. Now, Kareem, how have you been this last year?
Been very good, Kitty, and enjoying the brilliant work that is happening in all of the molecule. And personally, everything is great with us as well. We're surviving the times and making the best out of them.
So have you been playing much streams over the lockdown?
Yes, indeed. And actually, it is worth mentioning that the difference in Dreams now in comparison to the when it first came out in early access in 2019 now, but it's unbelievable. The quality of every single aspect, the quality of the content, the presentation of the content, the events, the originals coming from Media Molecule, the community work, it's baffling. And I definitely have been blown away by the trajectory of where it's at. I've just played it recently and I was really humbled.
Have any particular dreams stood out to you this year?
Yes, indeed. There were some that really stood out to me. I really love the team that do the, I don't know how to pronounce it, Noguchi's Bell series?
Noguchi's Bell, yes, yes.
Yeah, I am blown away by that, especially the animation and the humor and the set design. It's really, I keep my eye on that team. I always love the Snowball, the work from Bison, blows my mind. It's very sentimental, always touches your heart. Martin Neblong's Castle Dreams with Prologue, it continues to astound me how new techniques he unravels every day and posts all that work and all these techniques to share with everybody. It's amazing. The Idyllium, unbelievable virtual exposition and gallery. The Lady of Shalott is a nice sculpture. But also Media Molecule's work, from Ancient Danger to Mega Penguin, the Impies, the All Hallows. It's very important not to forget that and how amazing the collabs between Media Molecule and the community have come on. Seeing something like Mega Penguin especially, it's out there where an IP is invented from a Media Molecule, taken away by the community, interweaves to create a saga and a mythology, something else. And I am very impressed by the outreach work as well with the Ghostbusters and all that. So much to talk about.
So what is your favorite kind of content, or what do you look for when you're dream surfing?
I like art that it becomes something else. I've always liked that in music, where the intention and where it starts isn't where it ends at all. And I think, of course, I like the intention and work as well, like a nice solid platformer, nice and sweet. But for me, I'm very intrigued by work that evolves and changes into something else, a metamorph. So something like the Castle Dreams with Prologue is a good example of that. It's open, it could go in any direction.
Takes you on a journey, an unexpected journey. Now, have you got any special words of wisdom or messages you'd like to give to the Dreamiverse and all the creators?
The one piece of advice that I give myself as well as everyone is always don't overthink. Never overthink. Don't fall into the trap of trying to do a masterpiece. A masterpiece is an afterthought. It's an invention by history. It's a term given to work after it's done. It's the most crippling idea to try to do a masterpiece. The best idea is just doing. But doing a masterpiece, not so much.
Feel it, don't think about it.
Yeah, and if it ends up becoming amazing, better. Who doesn't want that? But like, I think it's quite daunting. It's more exciting to, and I'm sure everybody knows that, but getting started, following that trail, even if you have like just one bit of music in mind or one image or one character design, that's enough to begin.
Now, thank you so much, Kareem, for joining us. I hope you enjoy the show after this, and make sure you go and play the Impy's Hub because it's fabulous.
We'll do that right now. We'll do that right now. And I love your beautiful outfit as well.
Thank you, darling. See you later. Bye. We're joined now by some of the lovely molecules who joined forces to create the amazing Impy's Hub that you may or may not have already seen. If you haven't, go and check it out after the show. Ollie, Jamie, Ed, and Theo. Say hello, boys.
Hello, boys.
Hello boys.
I've got some questions for you. Which dream stood out for you this year? Which were your top dreams? Ollie, let's start with you.
Yeah, sure. So I've got three in mind. One is Hypertronic's Sounds from the Underground album. It's just beautifully presented, really good production value. Just two thumbs up. And the next one is Sleep Paralysis from our Dreams rap community. There's lots of names I have to shout out, but you know who you are. And for games, I really liked Triangle is Sentient by It's Me, Juvie, which is really great puzzles, minimal design, and just flawlessly executed.
Yes, I played that one as well. It was very good. What about you, Jamie?
Well, my 2021 jam was Toasty Bird, which is like the coolest thing ever. It's about this pigeon that like walks around. It's got like a slice of toast around its neck.
Oh, yes.
It's amazing, and you attract like other pigeons to your pigeon posse. I think they're pigeons. and there's like bad-tempered seagulls to dodge. It's a mysterious fountain in the middle. It's an actual masterpiece.
I did play, and it was wonderful. Very, very. It was a meme factory. What about you, Ed?
I think in a really general sense, there's just been loads and loads of really interesting ways that the music community have collaborated this year. And the seeing those sort of evolve and sort of carry on over the year has been really interesting. Whether it's like the Monday night group that meet and show off all their stuff, or whether it's just the sort of chats that happen on the various audio discords, I think there's just so many really interesting and exciting ways that musicians can get involved and team up and work with each other. Whether that's like, you know, Venwave and his sort of punk pop sort of style that he does with Kitaya, or whether that's like the sort of really electronic side of the spectrum, whether that's like, you know, Baff and Tin Boy and those sort of artists. There's just been loads and loads of really cool collabs. And so I'm going to deflect and just say music. Sorry.
Theo, what are your dreams of the year?
My dream of the year, or I guess technically it's just a scene, is the Idyllium. And I think lots of people were is impressed by me with that one. I think as a kind of an artistic achievement, it's just so fun. It's great to walk around and explore, and you know, you can play it multiple times and still be kind of discovering things. But you know, as a technical achievement, it's just in one scene, and it's very, very impressive. You find yourself walking around it, you're like, this keeps going. Like, how they fill this in. So for me, that was definitely a highlight.
My next question is a bit more sort of about how you dream surf. So what I'd like to know is, have you got any thing you specifically look for when you're dream surfing, or any tips about the good places to look for things? What about you, Jamie?
Easy, silly animal platformers. I was just looking at like the stuff that I play, and it's just all like one I really enjoyed. I think when I was interviewed a couple of years ago for the MPs was Cat Pile, which is like a half like tycoon sim, half platformer, and that was brilliant. And of course, I love Toasty Bird. And this is the creation I want to shout out by Comery, I think. It's roughly translated to The Duck Comes Home, where he plays like a duck in this like really low poly sort of scene. I just love these games. Like, just send me any animal platformers. I'm all over those.
We are biased, aren't you? What about you, Ed?
I really think Dreams sort of excels when you look for short experiences. And this year, rather recently, a user called Kaduko has set up a set of challenges called, a website called Dream Stats. And there's a tournament on there that you can take part and play at the same time as other people. And it sort of focuses on a lot of the really small arcade games. So things like Neon Shooties, which is exactly what you expect it to be, like, you know, spaceship shooting Neon Shooties. And Dorian's mini games, those kind of things, or even like if it's just a short experience from someone like Arseny 3D, or a scene from Bad Robo, something that I can sort of dip in and out on in like 30 seconds and give a thumbs up to. And this year there's been just tons of them.
Now, the last question is, do you have, we've lost someone. Should we wait till he's back?
It'll be lost.
Hello, Ollie.
Ollie. Wardrobe change, Ollie?
We're live, Ollie. You can't do that. Anyway, Ollie, I'm going to ask you, have you got any special messages for the Dreams community?
It's a little bit corny, but I think it's important. Always let what you find cool and interesting guide your creativity, because at the end of the day, that's what makes your creative voice unique. And like, it's just a bonus if it's on trend or not. Trends are cyclical. It'll happen eventually. But yeah, just do you as well as you can.
Just do you, kittens.
Do you.
What about you, Jamie?
I was going to go corny, but I'm just going to go straight out there and say liberal your keyframes. I'm a total hypocrite for that, and your life will just be so much easier. Liberal your keyframes.
Label your keyframes. You should have a T-shirt made with that on it.
Yes.
Ed, what about you?
I love that Jamie said label his keyframes, because the amount of keyframes I've had to go through of Jamie's work that aren't labeled.
Yep.
I would say find joy in the process and let your learning sort of unlock the fun. So when you find something difficult, sort of embrace that and make that part of what you're making.
Well, Theo, now that you've moved to a different corner, I'm going to ask you the same question. Have you got a special message for the Dreams community?
I think that the one thing I'd say is to not necessarily worry if what you're creating is the best stuff that you could do or the best stuff you can do, you know, with the time given, but keep putting stuff out there, keep delivering stuff, because eventually your quality will increase and increase. And then, you know, you'll look back in months' time and be like, wow, you know, I can do double the quality in half the time. And the only other thing, lighting will always save your scenes. If you're thinking, wow, my environments aren't looking so great, it's all lighting.
You can light anything and make it look good with the right lights. Well, nearly anything, even me. Anyway, thank you, boys, for joining us. Enjoy the show. And thank you for the amazing IMPYS Hub and everyone else that worked on it as well. See you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm joined now by another group of lovely molecules, the lovely Matt, Dave, Christoph, and Lisa. What dreams have stood out for you this year?
I think for me, a lot of dreams that have stood out have been a lot of really cool music creations. There's all the Halloween music videos that were amazing, and then some smaller creations or creators making really cool personal music that I really, really enjoyed.
I really enjoy like the non-traditional stuff that has been made this year, you know, like some just like contemplative art or like some minimal narrative or like some absolutely zero help at all, but you're inside these rooms and you have to imagine and understand on your own what you have to do and stuff. And I'm really into this kind of experience.
Any specific titles we can look for?
Oh, yes, I do. I really love like Liminality from WX. I mean, I love everything he made. Like, it's just that kind of thing. Like, it's just like mastering the art of like minimal narrative and stuff. And like, or like some crazy stuff, like, you know, like a prehistoric love from Edekozy. I really like that. Just like silliness of using Dream for just making art or like, you know, just a cover, whatever. I just love it.
Awesome. And last but not least, the lovely Lisa.
Hello. My game of the year was Pet Cafe. What a game. Yeah. So good. love it. And I am going to piggyback on what everyone else is saying. Music creations. Music is my love. So I especially really appreciate people who sing in Dreams because, and they make their vocals remixable. I'm working on a Masher Buttons remix at the moment. I hope I do it justice. But yeah, love all the vocalists in Dreams and all the rhythm games. Very good. Pet Cafe. Awesome.
Have you got any special messages to the community in the Dreamiverse? Starting with Matt.
Yeah, keep helping each other. In the Discords and on Twitter, it's great seeing everyone kind of working together on collaborations and like the weekly challenges. Like those are kind of my favorite kind of things. Like Notre Dame is now hosting the weekly Dream Challenge, and that's great stuff. And I love seeing that every week.
What about you, Dave?
The thing that comes to my mind is to persevere, because if you're finding any difficulty of any kind trying to make a certain thing and coming from an animation background, that's immediately, I think, animation issues. How could I get around that? But the thing you need to remember is that there's never, ever just one way to do anything in Dreams. There's always a bunch of ways to go about doing what you, to get to the destination that you want to arrive at. There's a lot of journeys you can take. Just persevere. If something doesn't work out, ask the community. They're a good bunch out there. And you probably get a fresh idea on how to do what you need to do.
Good advice. What about you, Christoph?
I was about to say persevere, but it's been like famously well said by Dave, so I'm not going to go on that. But I would say I've seen like a lot of creation that are like really good in one aspect. Imagine like art, for example. The art is absolutely amazing, but like the logic is less good, or like the UI is less good. But like Matt was saying, like some guys are really, really mastering the UI or like the logic, and I think it's all about like jumping the step about asking, because I know like some of us and like some of, you know, like the community like feel a bit too shy, like shall I ask, will they say no? Well, if you don't ask, nobody will say yes, so I would say yeah, just go for it, you know, on like any social media. And I'm into the logic, but I have like a UI like graphic background, and I really appreciate like anyone who put like some love in the UI, and especially like the screen cover. Like when a dream or like a got like a really wonderful crafted picture with lots of attention, that's where I click. I do dig those.
Excellent. What about you, Lisa?
It takes some bravery to upload yourself singing. So, and you know, that goes beyond just vocals. Like, I appreciate the courage that people take to kind of put themselves out there. So don't be shy. Yeah. Don't be afraid to share your stuff, because we appreciate it.
Yeah, be brave.
Yes.
Excellent. Thank you all for joining us. And I hope you enjoy the show shortly. And if you haven't already, check out the Impy's Hub. I'm sure most of you probably already worked on it. So, anyway, it's lovely to see you all.
Thank you, Kitty.
Enjoy the show. Bye.
Bye.
Joined now by some of the lovely molecules that have joined us this year. Lovely Erin, Maggie, Ailey, and JJ. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hi.
You excited for the Impies?
Yes.
Yeah.
Starting shortly. Since this is all about the Impies, tell us which dreams this year have stood out for you that you think might win one. Erin, let's start with you.
The game that I'm looking forward to the most is Lullaby for a Beagle in the art direction category. And I think it was by Ghost Fruit 64. And I really love those 3D Fleck paintings. And yeah, I really hope to see more of those, and I hope they do really well. Yeah.
So I think the best dream I saw on Dreams this year was Triangle Sentient. Like the art direction of that game and the color schemes and the gameplay, it's all so pretty and so well put together. It just blew my mind. Like it looks amazing.
Yeah, my favorite dream that I played this year would have to be Liminal Mystery Box, which was like a collection of kind of vignettes based around playing with perception and really just sort of playing with your expectations of what a first-person game can be. It's really, really cool and a really kind of cool framework for it, in that there's loads of floors and each floor has a different room, and so they can keep being updated and adding new cool little vignettes. So yeah, I'm excited to kind of see that be evolved and more little games be added there.
Sounds exciting. I haven't tried that one yet. What about you, Ailee?
Probably my favorite dream was Pet Cafe by Messy Artist. That game, I'm a huge fan of rhythm games in general. And there was something about that game that hit the nail on the head, which was just focus on the audio cues and relax into it. And the atmosphere and everything like that, I could just like totally chill out and throw croissants at cats and dogs. I just loved it. So yeah, that was my favorite dream for sure.
I'd like to know a little bit more about your dream surfing habits and if you've got any top tips for how you dream surf, because there's many ways you can dream surf and different pages you can look at. Where do you normally go and what do you look for?
The things that will keep me interested is usually a flavor of comedy involved in it. So they'll like, that's kind of what I look for whenever I'm looking for games and dreams in general.
Yeah.
What makes me laugh?
Look at JJ, he's making me laugh right now.
Yeah, I know.
Erin, what about you?
Yeah, my favourite dreams are the really short ones that are quite experimental, kind of like the painting ones or like little experiences rather than games. I find that because of the tools that Dreams gives its users, you can do so many cool, fun and innovative things, and that's what I personally try to look for. Especially when I'm surfing, if I can find a dreamer that's made something, I'll go to their profile and try and look at the rest of the stuff they've done as well.
Good tip. I do that as well. Now, what about you, JJ, you cool dude?
Oh, well, when I'm checking out the Dreamiverse, I play a lot with my brother. Like on the couch, kind of like, so we will basically just look for anything that's got any kind of multiplayer that you can play on one screen. And there are quite a lot of games out there, and we'll basically just like search for those every time. I think the biggest thing about those is because there are a lot, and you know, especially when you're playing something with somebody else, your kind of like attention span is pretty short. So it's anything that can kind of grab you mechanically within like a minute or so is really important. But once you've got us in there, like we'll spend hours on one little mini game because it's great fun. So
excellent. Now, last but not least, I'm going to ask you, have you got any special messages or words of wisdom for the Dreams community?
My wisdom is, I mean, I guess it's similar to what I to the other question, but I think you need to make sure that you can make the rules and mechanics of your game very clear immediately, because I play a lot of Dreams, they don't really have, like, they have really cool gameplay ideas, but they don't really have tutorials and they don't really teach the player how to play. So I would say that it's really important to just take that little extra time and make sure that somebody coming in who's never seen the game before is going to be able to immediately know what they're doing. And that's going to be, yeah, that's going to let just so many more people see the really cool stuff that you've done that otherwise they might just immediately go away from if they've got a really short attention span, which most people do.
What were you saying? Sorry. joke.
Bits of words of wisdom maybe would just be to sort of share what you can, share what you do with other people. Like, I think the really special thing about Dreams is the ecosystem that exists within it. And just share what you can, share the love.
So I saw this the other day, and I think the best thing you can make in Dreams is a friend. And I'm talking this from the bottom of my heart. Hi, Tom. I just want to say that the best thing you can do is just collaborate with the others and help each other. And sometimes when you go online and see someone struggling with like a piece of logic or some sculpt, whatever it is, and if you help them solve this stupid issue they have, and like unblocks them with their creative process. It means so much to them. And like, you should be doing that. And that's just what I want to say.
Oh, excellent. Well, thank you all for joining me today. I hope you're looking forward to the Impy Awards that's starting shortly. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing who wins. I'll see you all soon.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
And now we're joined by two lovely, lovely molecules who both contributed to the recent Dream Shaping Reshaped update, amongst many other people and other things. How are you both, Kat and Kev?
I'm amazing.
Great. You looking forward to the Impy Awards?
I am stoked.
I want to know, what are your top dreams of the last year?
So there was a music video that I really loved that released, I believe, almost a year ago now. But of course, then it didn't make it in time for the IMPYS last year, called Please Stand By, which was made by Grim Pinata 136. But it was using the track Telepaths by Sourceless One. And I really, really liked that just because it was, I don't know, bit different and something nice to listen to. So I loved Cock's World by Kitaya Net, and also just, you know, watching Brian Cox respond to it on live stream was just the
best.
That
was hilarious because he had to smile even though it was really weird.
It was so weird, so weird, and it just got weirder and weirder and weirder. And then another one as well was Patient Patrol by Danny Kaka. You're trying to get people to a hospital in time. It reminds me of a game I used to play a lot and I really enjoyed playing it.
What about you, Kevin?
I thought I'd shout out just more asset creators, really, because I noticed a lot, as Kat and I have been doing some templates and things like that, I've been looking at the community templates, and so I wanted to shout out to those users who've not only made a game, but tried to make that game available to other people to build upon. So Wibble Wobble is a very recent one that most people will know of. Starfighter Gemini by The Tenure is a really good one, and really quite an old one from last year, Turbo Racing Unlimited by Prince Laser. It's a great racing game, but also has the assets there for you to build your own version, which I think is awesome. And then just for assets themselves rather than games, I'm going to pronounce this wrong, Nefrendil has been making lots and lots of assets, all sorts of things from barrels to daffodils to birds. And I just love anyone who's sort of adding to the community's library of things to build with. So well done, all of you, and anyone else who's doing the same.
Now, before we finish, I would like to know if you've got any special messages or pearls of wisdom for the Dreams community.
Does this sound cheesy? I don't know. You do you, right? So create what you want within reason. Okay, like, you don't want to be moderated, but don't ever let anyone think that your idea is silly. Make what you want the world to see.
It's pretty hard to follow that. I mean, that's basically what I think. But I think keep making, hark back to the asset creation. I think, yeah, it's nothing wrong with just being someone who made the bush that went in a brilliant game, like, or making, you know, I made that gun that character in that other game is holding. So to all you people out there who just like modeling something or just making something small for other people to use, to keep doing it because it's what makes Dreams really special.
I made a few assets in my time because I'm better at sculpting than I am at logic. So I've got collections in my profile and it is lovely seeing how people use them. Like, I've got a tree that I made way back in the day that people still use, and my cakes and my little dungeony things and all that. So I can highly recommend it. Thank you both for coming.
Thank you.
To the awards. I shall see you there.
You too.
Your dress is amazing.
Yes.
That's absolutely fantastic outfit you're wearing, Kitty.
Oh, darlings. You know this whole thing. I just woke up like this.
Oh,
there we go. A trowel. That's my top tip. Anyway, bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Sure, you could sit and listen to me waffle all night, kittens, but I'm afraid we've run out of time. It's the end of the pre-show party. I'd like to thank all the lovely molecules that joined me with all their pearls of wisdom. And now, without further ado, it's time to discover, dun, 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 who's won one of these gorgeous creatures. It's the Impies.
possibly ever eat. It's just three ingredients. It's a Twinkie Wiener sandwich. There's a world
annual Impy Awards. We are so glad you've joined us for this very special event in this glamorous venue.
A cardboard box.
Absolutely stunning and only mildly flammable.
The show budget was tight this year, but luckily we at Media Molecule are partial to a bit of papercraft. Isn't that right, Jen?
That's right, Tom. And we love a good celebration. So once a year, every year, we throw a big party to celebrate the Dreams community and everything it stands for.
Well, you can't stand for anything. You haven't got any legs. You're just one big arm under there.
30 seconds into the show and you've already broken the fourth wall. You've ruined their immersion. No point doing a sock puppet show now, is there? Oh, well, it's probably for the best.
Wait. No, she was so young. She hadn't even been washed yet. Oh, God, no, Jen.
Tom, I'm going to need a hand up here presenting the show.
Oh, yeah.
Look, I love puppets as much as anyone, but it kind of feels right to be presenting the Impies in person this year.
True. And hey, look at this place. We've even got a ceiling this year. Fancy.
Yeah, hopefully we don't get any giant monsters showing up to punch through it. We've had a real problem with that in past shows.
Yeah, it's weird. We have double-checked security this year, right?
Mecha Whale's on holiday in Ibiza this year anyway. Look, I got a postcard.
Total party animal.
Anyway, where were we? Oh yeah, the Impy Awards. Hyping up the Dreams community, handing out trophies, all that good stuff.
It's been another inspiring 12 months in the Dreamiverse, one defined by collaborative community spirit more than ever. And because of that, our Impy's Hub looks a little bit different this year.
Available to play in Dreams right now, it's not just focused on the awards. Instead, us Molecules have built a curated exhibition designed to celebrate the Dreams community as a whole, with exhibits inspired by just some of the community-led moments that have really brought us all together across Dreams' lifetime.
What a year 2021 was for Dreams, though. We had creators teaming up to bring such ambitious projects to life, such as the music festival Dreams Fest and the amusement park slash concert Flow World. Inventive community challenges set by people like Legend of Sketchy and Magma Monster brought together even more people from across the Dreamiverse.
It's been a bumper year for breakout dreamers. Fluxy Marks, It's Me Juvie, Keenado, not to mention a little someone called Stank Hank. It's a long story involving banjos. We'll catch you up later.
Hold on, I'm getting something in my earpiece. I'm being reminded that Medium Molecule also did some cool stuff in the Dreamiverse this year.
Phew, the community was starting to show us up a bit there.
What else is new? Yes, this year we introduced the world to Mega Penguin and invited you to help tell the story of his adventures through the Dreamiverse. Virtual convention Dreamscom arrived to show off your inventive booths and game demos, complete with multiple days of streams, blog posts, and even a magazine.
Our Halloween event, All Hallows Dreams, featured a huge collaborative ghost train built by dreamers. And we can't forget the massive Dungeons update, which added a brand new dungeon crawling campaign and revamped dream shaping to help even more people get to grips with creating in dreams. And for our last trick, for this year's Impies, we revamped our awards categories to match and to better represent the diverse array of roles that all of you play as part of this community. Because, hang on, let me just put on my corny but true hat. Because Dreams isn't just about creating stuff, it's about the connections we make with each other.
Tonight is all about you, of course, the community. We say this a lot, but you make Dreams what it is. Whether you're creating hours-long adventures, cool tunes, beautiful art, or simply supporting one another, you can be safe in the knowledge that whatever you're doing in Dreams, you're inspiring all of us.
Tom, you inspire me every day. Sorry, it's the hat. Down to business. Every creation you see nominated here tonight is an original creation that's been made in and can only be found in Dreams.
The judging was intense before we decided to take the process outside of the tents. With the help of our panel of judges, including many of our molecules, our studio directors, and plenty of our friends from across all sorts of creative industries, we managed to whittle down your nominations.
Tonight's nominees and winners don't represent everything in Dreams that's worthy of a trophy. Otherwise, we'd literally be here for the next half a year and manufacturing costs would bankrupt us. But it is a wonderful selection of some of the best stuff that happened in the Dreamiverse this year.
Let's get into it, shall we?
Yeah, go on then.
Our first award is for excellence in art direction. Tough gig going first. I hope they're not nervous.
This stuff exists to be looked at. It's probably fine.
Technically, Cuthbert exists to be looked at. And look how he turned out.
Fair point. This Impy recognises a creation that displays a consistent level of quality and style through its visual design.
The nominees are...
And the winner is... The Idyllium!
A massive congratulations to Zeke, Beavis2, and Helicosi, and a huge thank you to Anna Hollenrake from Mediatonic, our guest judge for this category.
Next up, excellence in environment art.
This award celebrates the power of a compelling world. Gorgeous vistas, detailed lighting.
Islands made up of the bodies of your favourite characters.
What?
That was a thing this year. The one character, one world challenge.
Is the Dreams community okay?
They're better than okay, Tom. They're creative. The nominees are
And the winner is... Tales from Darktown Red Zone.
Congratulations to Dirty Flusher, and a massive thank you to our guest judge for this category, Holly Bennett from Frontier.
What's up, Dreams community? It's me, Greg Miller from Kinda Funny Games, and I had to come through to congratulate you on another year of creating in Dreams. You all know I'm a huge fan of everything you come up with, but of course this year was incredibly special. Why? You made a Ghostbusters game. Are you kidding me? You made a Ghostbusters game, ladies and gentlemen. That's all you need. You know what I mean? It's one of those, were there other great creations in Dreams this year's, year? Of course there were. Were they Ghostbusters? Actually, a few of them were, of course, on Dreams, my banner. Picture is still the Ecto one that you guys made in Dreams. It doesn't matter. What I'm saying is I'm glad you chase your passions. Like my passion, Ghostbusters and Dreams and PlayStation. But you know what I mean? You made a Ghostbusters game!
Jen?
Yes, Tom?
Will you tell me a story?
Sure thing. Once upon a time, there were two little sock puppets who couldn't stop flapping their mouths to present an award show without making us look silly. And they were never heard from again.
Did you just make that up?
Yep. But it doesn't hold a candle to some of the stories that were told in Dreams this year. The Award for Excellence in Narrative recognises storytelling that made us laugh, cry, and kept us hooked until the very end.
The nominees are...
Just disappear out of thin air. Something happened to them. And to make it even better, police sent someone.
I was really rooting for it in the beginning, but about halfway through, well, let's just say the light wasn't so bright at the end of the tunnel.
And the winner is... The War to End All Wars!
Congratulations to Deander 96, and a massive thank you to Hannah Rutherford, our guest judge on that category. So, Jacob, up 3 points.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh man, maybe you could ask Chloe for some pointers actually.
I would have thought about that, yeah. Oh my head! That was such a long way to fall, Jen.
Yeah, you are looking a bit limp.
I can't believe they just cast us off like that. We were supposed to be the stars of the show this year. I feel so empty.
Well, if you hadn't broken the fourth wall, we'd still be full of hand right now, you plum. They're very serious about looking professional this year.
What are we going to do? We can't let them steal our spotlight. I got my hair done especially for this.
Same thing we always do, my friend. Ask the Dreamiverse for help.
What's good? I'm Jay Garcia from Kinda Funny's PlayStation podcast, PS I Love You, XOXO. To me, Dreams is a nesting doll for art. It's something that took immense creativity to develop, and that development gave way to so many more creations since then. Dream surfing is one of my favorite activities, and it seems like whatever I type into the search bar produces more than I could ever imagine playing. I mean, there's VR, there's multiplayer, there's movies, music, hyper-realistic breakfast foods, and between that, there's also just so many opportunities for collaborations within that. And even beyond the dream surfing and checking out people's creations, I remember being really enamored by the campaign of the game and the diversity within that and how many things you can make. It's always so impressive to see how people use the tools to create such like a wide variety of things from the developers to the players. So I just want to say thanks for having me as a judge for creation of the year. And here's to many more years of dreams.
Now it's time to hand out the award for excellence in sculpture. This year, we've seen Dreams creators shape some incredible things, using nothing but Dreams sculpting tools in their very own hands. Or controllers?
Hands. The original controllers.
Wow. Really makes you think. Here are the nominees.
And the winner is Joy.
Congratulations, Go-Go Saint. And a huge shout out to our guest judge for this category, Anna Hollenrake, again.
Hello, Dreams community, all of our friends at Media Molecule. My name is Brian Fleming. I'm all the way out here at Sucker Punch in Seattle, and I just wanted to pop in and say hi to everybody today, offer huge congratulations to everybody who made the Impy Awards shortlist. I love playing games, but I think I enjoy making games even more, and Dreams is about, you know, democratizing that, giving everyone the opportunity and the experience of creating games and watching people play them. And tonight we get a look at the very, very best of that group for the year. So congratulations for all the people who made the list. Good luck to you all and keep on dreaming.
This is a good one. Music Track of the Year. This award recognizes an unforgettable single piece of music composed and created in Dreams this year.
Let's have a listen to our nominees.
Come again and catch a fire when I'm spitting the embers. Living in me is a spirit on a mission of vengeance. Running numbers used to come into the fires and spit. You better call your ghost rider because I'm doing you sick. Like terminal, hospice, you on your deathbed. I'm leaving flowers and notice they're saying that you got the mouth, but you better soon because I'm so philanthropic. Woo! Who stop it? I be chilling like a villain in a cockpit. Moon walking in the stars like a rocket. Destiny arising like
the big bad bass is not real, and it can't hurt you. Or can it?
I raise the ball when you raise the stakes. Lugatti in the right, can't get me to shake the place. Nobody gonna be ready for what will be taking shape. Better keep up, cause we can't change the pace. No, we ain't changing the pace. I raise the ball.
And the winner is Starlight!
A huge congratulations to Prince Tara, and a massive thank you to our celebrity guest judge, Luca from OFK.
Rolling straight on into our Musician of the Year category. This award goes out to someone who's displayed a mastery of the audio tools in Dreams, gracing us with excellent standalone tunes, entire albums, or soundtracks.
Our nominees are
Harmony,
And the winner is...
R.A. Kio!
Congratulations, R.A. Kio, and a massive thanks to our guest judge for this category, Barry Topping, composer of the soundtrack for Paradise Killer.
Hi! Okay, so I want to write a song about a dream. But not like, I feel like a lot of songs are about like dreams and imagination, which is important. But I want to do a song about a dream where I'm maybe having an argument with someone. Like, okay, I had a dream the other day that I was driving. I was driving with my friend from high school, and she was so mad. And I just think that that could be a song. Anyway, hi, I'm Luca Lafay, lead singer of the band OFK. From the upcoming series on PlayStation, We Are OFK. Thanks so much, Media Molecule, for having us. It was a huge honor for us to judge music for the Impy Awards. This is our first time on this side of judging, and we know how stressful it is to submit, and then to wait, and then to find out the results. It's just a lot. And all the entries this year are so inspiring, and it's incredibly cool to see the creative music community in dreams. We're floored seeing all the incredible work you all are making. And honestly, congrats to anyone who managed to just finish a song and put it out this year. It doesn't always feel like it, but that's a massive achievement. So keep it up in 2022, y'all. Big love from all of us at OFK.
Let's keep the momentum going with excellence in animation. This one's for the movers and shakers of dreams. You know, because they're moving and shaking their controllers to animate.
I can't believe I made you say that with your actual mouth.
You know what's cool? Cheese.
Yeah, no, I definitely wrote this. Let's see the nominees.
It's good to see you.
And the winner is... Solar Blast!
Congratulations, Paolo, and a huge thank you to our guest judges on this category, George Rao from Aardman and Patsy the Puppy.
Hi, this is Alex Helfrecht. I'm the director of A Winter's Journey. We are so proud to be using dreams as a fundamental part of the filmmaking. The talent that you all are showing online and in the Dreamiverse is extraordinary, and it's a filmmaker's playground. So I just wanted to say, keep doing what you're doing. It's fabulous, and it's just a gateway to immense creativity across countries and across the world. Thank you so much.
Gameplay. We all love it. In moderation, of course. But what makes gameplay excellent, apart from the ability to pat a dog on the head? This Impy seeks to answer that question.
Our Excellence in Gameplay Award recognises the creations that offer the player refined, polished, and expertly executed ideas and mechanics. Our nominees are...
Press touchpad to start.
And the winner is Claustro Factory.
Well done, Acer, and a big thanks to our judges for this category. Lewis Pete from BAFTA Games and Stacey Jenkins from Sega.
Right, now we've got most original gameplay. There's a pretty straightforward explanation for this one. We're recognizing an interactive creation that features unique gameplay mechanics, the likes of which we've never seen
before. Here are the nominees.
And the winner is Impressionable.
Huge congratulations to Entropy, and a big thank you to our guest judge and the world's number one horsey fan, Sarah Podzorski from MinMax.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Keighley from that other awards show, the Game Awards. Just wanted to stop by the IMPYS and say I am so impressed by everything that this community creates in Dreams. A few weeks ago, I remember scrolling through my Twitter feed and seeing this insane Jurassic Park recreation that someone in the world had done. So I'm gonna be watching the show just to find out what you guys have made in Dreams. It's really so inspiring to me to see what users create in a platform like Dreams. I think users and creators around the world like you guys are the future of the video game industry, and I hope we'll see some of you on stage one year at the Game Awards winning an award for your creations. Have a great show and keep creating in Dreams. Anything truly is possible.
Yes! New high score. Take that, Jacob.
That is a rotary phone. There are no games on it.
Oh, sorry. I'm meant to be calling people for help, aren't I? Right, who's got the muscles to crash this show?
Oh, you know who we could call?
Who's that?
Hypatia, you know the dragon from Hit Dungeon Crawler, Ancient Dangers, Bat's Tale, exclusively available to play in Dreams right now.
I'm sorry. Is not available right now. Please leave a message after the beep. Beep.
Ah, it was worth a shot. Do you know who's good at evil schemes?
Who?
I'm going to give them a call.
Thank you for calling Beach Corp customer support. Your call is important to us. You are number 894 in the queue.
No, this is going to take ages. I'm just going to call him directly.
I know it's you two. You've got to stop calling me. I'm a very important CEO of a very benign company that's doing all it can to take over, deliver stuff to the world. I've got to go.
Wow.
Ooh.
Okay.
Yikes.
Not them.
Haruka?
Nope. Never.
Okay, what about Buffbutt?
I did think that, but he's not going to do it for free.
Ooh, Astro Thumbs.
Jen, they're useless. They're all thumbs. Ah, it's no good. We really need someone with a thirst for destruction, who has absolutely no remorse, and a stone-cold soul. Wait, I've got it.
This year brought something new to the Dreamiverse, a dedicated curation and editorial team designed to help you and the rest of the world discover as many dazzling Dreamiverse gems as possible, both in-game and out.
So we thought it would only be right to present the award for excellence in curation from the headquarters of Dreams' official publication, The Impsider.
Mm-hmm. But first, we're going to plug a couple of things. First up, our Impy's themed section of the front page of Dream Surfing, lovingly put together by our curators, Ali and Jacob, and just celebrating a bunch of cool moments from the past year in Dreams. Go check it out.
Also, we made another magazine this year. Presented by The Impsider, this handy guide to this year's Impy's exhibition is available to download on indreams.me for free. In hindsight, we probably should have printed it.
Anyway, it's full of extra info and insights into the Impy's hub that we made this year, plus words from our very own community on all their favourite creations of the year. Make sure to download your copy.
But back to the show and our Excellence in Curation Award. This award recognises those community members who dedicate their time to putting together collections and highlighting others' work. The nominees are... Winner is Trix 9.
Well done, Trix. Our guest judge for excellence in curation was John Gibson from IM8bit. Thank you so much, John. Newsroom. I'm interested, but I'm gonna need more details. Sounds juicy. Can you get it to me today?
Jen, get off the phone. We're in the middle of the show.
Jacob, who's got a massive scoop for us.
Oh, exciting. I'll have a mint chocolate chip.
Did you hear that, Jacob? Yeah. And I'll have a raspberry ripple. Did I do that?
I don't know, but we should get back to the Impy stage for safety. Right. Time for the award for excellence in character design. We've met some truly memorable characters in the Dreamiverse this year. This award recognises the characters that have won our hearts with personality and originality. Here are our nominees.
The winner is... Commonote!
Congratulations to FaZe PS, and thank you to Paul Abbott from Aardman for being our guest judge on that category.
Ooh, I am completely blanking on what's next. What the f-?
Oh yeah, excellence in audio design. That's what's next.
Just air horn is not audio design.
We've got some very talented nominees here who have creatively and carefully implemented air horn, I mean audio, in their creations. Let's take a...
Yeah. How do I understand? Change perspective.
Good evening, Aaron Ford. For those of you new to the show, my name is Sean, and I'm your host. We got a lot of stuff to talk about on the show tonight.
Whoa there, hold your horses. Before you go designing factories for actual clients, you need to go through training first.
And the winner is... Fragments!
How did I get here? Oh, gotta get rid of those noises.
Congratulations to Optimus Cries, Nico Jax, and Thion for picking up that award. And a huge thank you to Kenny Young for being our guest judge.
Right, this next one's an exciting one. Excellence in innovation.
We're talking some of the most inventive, unique, and boundary-pushing Dreams creations of the year, whether it's a game or something else entirely.
Which is why I'm delighted to present the award to Jamie Breeze's Sausage Cannon!
No, Jen. Molecules can't win Impies, remember?
This is devastating news. I've already put at least three in the boot of my car.
Not sure if you're talking about Impies or our co-workers. I'm not going to ask. Here are our nominees. Round of applause to Danny Kaka and the team behind Nine Equals, and a massive thank you to our guest judge, Richard Lemarchand from the USC.
The sausage cannon! You've angered him! This is officially a worst-case scenario. Worst?
Jen.
Hi, I'm Carol Chung, a lead producer at Santa Monica Studio. Congratulations to all the participants and nominees in the third annual IMPYS 2022. The Dreams community is endlessly surprising and delightful. Thank you so much for sharing and creating in Dreams. Happy IMPYS, everyone.
Now, in the spirit of community, we move to our first community voted award of the night, Community Star.
This IMPY is a special one, as the winner of this award has been judged by their peers to be an exemplary member of the Dreams community.
Whether they are fansite editors, podcasters, streamers, players or creators, these nominees have gone above and beyond in supporting the Dreams community. Here they are.
Here we go. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, DreamsCon 2021.
We got all warmed up, the conversation's flowing, like, this is what happens, and then I never want to end.
And the winner is... Keld Biones. Congratulations.
Another one for your collection, Keld.
Word. Seeing some of the Twitter promos that the team has been making, where you can see, like, concept art.
Oh, yeah.
Hello everyone, my name is Jan-Bart van Beek. I'm the studio art director here at Guerrilla Games. It's always amazing to see what people are making in Dreams, whether it's building their own worlds, or telling stories, or making games. It's just so clear how much talent is at display. Being a game maker myself, I really understand how much effort, time, love and passion goes into all the works that you make. I am in awe of all of you. Well done, and happy IMPYS 2022.
Voice acting can really make a creation, whether it's vocal work that lends personality to a character,
or narration that brings life to a story.
Voice actors are the unseen heroes of Dreams creations, which is why our Excellence in Voice Acting Award looks to give them their moment in the spotlight. Here are the nominees.
I'm currently on a planet known as Vasta Subterra. The first team of K-Bots that landed here never reported back, so now I get to explore and possibly die.
You need to tap it twice, then speak.
I tried that! I just don't have rabbit hands.
I'll keep him safe.
Well, it's all the same to me, mate. Just no acts of heroism on my ship. It's bad for business.
And live together forever and ever. Farewell.
Watch out, the British are coming. Oh! Hey, Broccoli Head, you get caught in the splash zone, yeah?
And the winner is... Red and the Cursed Isles!
See? Yeah, you're taking forever.
Okay, okay. I'm coming. It's hard to buckle with these gloves. So, what do you guys think?
Congratulations, Red Saikatsu, and a massive thank you to Sebastian Croteau, our guest judge for that category. Our next category is another community-voted one, Most Helpful Dreamer. To present this award, we thought we'd bring in a very special celebrity guest. Mega Penguin, are you there?
Mr. Penguin, it's an honor to have you on the show. And might I say, you scrub up very well. That's a lovely tux.
It's been a huge year for you in the Dreamiverse. First, you got stranded, but it doesn't seem like you found your fleet yet.
Looks like we've lost Mega Penguin, but thank you for that lovely and slightly confused speech. The nominees are...
Two jumps, right? At the beginning. If you double jump on both of them, then the triple jump doesn't work after that.
Tap circle to drop down just through one of them, and I've made it so that if I hold circle.
Classic slide puzzle. You maybe played with one of these as a kid. Right? If I press left, nothing happens. But if I press right or up, those work.
It definitely helps to have these stylized shapes, elements, and colors from the beginning.
And the winner is... Tap Giles!
Congratulations, Tappy G!
Hi, I'm Tara Saunders and I'm co-studio head at PlayStation's London studio. Dreams is a fantastic tool to empower and showcase your creativity. It's not about what you make being the best thing that you've ever done, but it's about what you learn and how it inspires your next creative project. So keep creating, keep showcasing your work in the IMPYS. I love seeing everything that you do.
Now it's time for a new award, Contribution Beyond Dreams. It's a bit of an abstract one, but that's only because we're lucky enough to have a community that represents Dreams not only through the game itself, but outside of it.
Contribution Beyond Dreams recognises those community members who use their skills through blogs, social media, streaming, podcasts, anything outside of the Dreamiverse to celebrate those within it. Let's see the nominees.
Started working on this track thingy for the Haunted House. Never finished it though because I didn't have time.
Hello everybody, welcome to episode 56 of the Made in Dreams podcast. Per usual, I'm your host, Mighty Fish.
We're showing off another top 10 of our favorite games and creations from the last week of PlayStation's Dreams on PS4.
Number 5, Mountain Walk by Martinity DK.
And the winner is the Made in Dreams podcast.
Congratulations, Will and James, our Dreams evangelists. And a heartfelt thanks to our judges for this category. NNE Saga and Katie and Tom from Into Games. The world shakes.
I don't think that was you. We may have a serious problem.
Shh, let's just keep going. You had one job. Give him some simple directions.
I did. I said go left, then right again.
The stage is right, then left again, you baked bean.
Oh, I was looking in the mirror the whole time we arrived. New haircut, remember?
Well, he's here somewhere, judging by the apocalyptic tremors. Let's find him, all right?
Would you like to hear a funny joke?
Oh yeah, the first one of the night. Lay it on me.
What do you say when you want to start a race in VR? Ready, headset, go! Let's see the nominees.
The winner is The Restless Dark.
Congratulations to S001 for that win, and a massive thank you to Ian Higton from Eurogamer for being our guest judge on that category.
Next up, another brand new award for the Impies. Evolving Experience.
Hello, Dreamers. Scott Rohde here from PlayStation Studios. I am super excited to be here for year 3 of the spectacular and irreplaceable Impies. It is always such a fun trip for me to get lost in all the creations that this amazing community continues to pull together. So thank you so much for your endless creativity. Couple of quick words about some of my favorites from this year. Data Boy by Justin Art. This one really reminded me of an all-time classic favorite from years past, Gunstar Heroes. Really nostalgic and fun. Thank you. Trips Voyage. Wow, what an amazing platformer with tons of unique mechanics. Loved that springy stick and lots of secrets to uncover. Thank you, Ufalace and Actual Jimmy Jam. which probably gets my vote for best creator name. I've also been spending some big chunks of time getting lost in the music of Dreams. There's some really cool audiovisual experiences out there. And just this morning, I checked out the Chemical Reaction EP by Forever Threeco and friends. Absolutely loved it. Nicely done. But perhaps my favorite dream of the year was a little game called Octagon by Angelotti. I'm sure I'm saying that name wrong, but loving the game. EDM meets twin stick shooter. Two of my favorite things, all wrapped up in one wonderful package. So, so good. Absolutely loved Octagon. So thanks again to Media Molecule for pulling together yet another great Impy's show. But most of all, thanks to you, the amazing Dreams community, for surprising me every single day. Keep it coming and enjoy the show.
It's been a little over 2 years since Dreams' launch, even longer since our beta and early access days. Since then, we've seen more and more creations grow and evolve, with Dreamers adding extra features, reinventing or even remastering the things they've made.
It inspired us to make room at the Impy's to celebrate the people who have committed to exploring the full potential of a single creation. Here are the nominees for Evolving Experience.
We're a bit understaffed these days.
And the winner is The Web.
A huge, huge well done to Cat135. And thanks to our guest judge for Evolving Experience, Khalif Adams from Spawn on Me.
Community collaboration is another new award category. It's been a bumper year for collaborations in the Dreamiverse, and we thought it only right to dedicate an award to it, with the winner voted for by you, the community.
There have been so many incredible moments of unity in the Dreamiverse this year, from community asset jams to collaborative shipbuilding, high score tournaments to entire music festivals. Again, this is what inspired this year's Impy's Hub, playable in Dreams right now. It's absolutely the spirit of Dreams, and it wouldn't exist without all of you.
A massive well done to anyone who stepped out of their comfort zone and got involved with a community initiative this year. And if you didn't, it's okay. There's a space for you whenever you're ready. Here's the shortlist for this year's Community Collaboration Award.
And the winner is Dreamsfest 2021!
Our last brand new
Yeah, that is getting louder now, isn't it? Probably just our breakthrough dreamer getting ready to bust through the wall, right?
Our last brand new, thank you, and community voted award of the night goes to the dreamer who joined the Dreamiverse in 2021 and in 1 year has left an indelible mark on our hearts with their personality, creativity, and passion.
The nominees for Breakthrough Dreamer are... And our winner is... Fluxy Mux! Woohoo! Did I say it right, Fluxy? Congratulations to everybody who shared their imaginings with us this year. The IMPYS is a really special time for us all. It's when we get to look back and reflect upon what was unique about the past year. And really, that uniqueness is driven by you, the creators. What I love about the Dreamiverse is the diversity of the content that you all share. Each team and each creator has their own style and their own approach, and that really shines through in the work that you share. Some things are deeply personal. Some things are mysterious and enigmatic. Some works are all about the gameplay or are deeply puzzling. Others bring community together around fantastic events, and some are just downright hilarious. There's not only one type of creator or one type of creation that stops us in our tracks here at Media Molecule. We think you're all amazing and we salute you. Thank you very much for entertaining us over this past year and wishing you a very happy IMPYS 2022. Somehow, we're down to our last two awards of the night.
And somehow, the set is still in one piece.
Don't jinx it.
Sorry.
Creator or Team of the Year is a biggie. And we've got a larger pool of nominees to match this year. There are so many solo creators and collaborative teams working at an astonishingly high level in Dreams.
For the first time, this esteemed category includes individual creators and entire teams. Let's see who shone brightest through the art they created, either on their own or as part of a group. The nominees are...
Right, mate, I'll tell you when I've had too many. You lousy pup. I'll trade anything you want for it.
No deal. This was my father's, and you don't have anything I want.
Oh, I'll tell you where the temple is.
Thank you.
there. Hold your horses. Before you go designing factories for actual clients, you need to go through training first.
And the winner of Creator or Team of the Year is... Ghostfruit 64!
Congratulations, Ghosty, and a huge thank you to Arex and Inel Tomlinson for being our guest judges on that category. And now for our last award of the night, Creation of the Year. This is a hugely significant award. Out of all of the creations we saw in the Dreamiverse this year, these nominees stood out as particularly brilliant examples.
This coveted Impy goes to a creation that excels in many different areas of its craft, from art to design to audio and much, much more, to create an experience that's one of the best in the Dreamiverse. The nominees are...
The old gods lived in a vast world full of beauty.
And the winner for Creation of the Year is the Idyllium.
Hi everyone, this is Herman Hulst, head of PlayStation Studios. Congratulations to Ghostfruit64 for earning Creator of the Year, and the Idyllium by Helicozy, Zeke and Beavis 2 for Creation of the Year. This last 12 months in Dreams has been an incredible celebration of collaboration and creativity. And as the head of PlayStation Studios, I understand how much love and effort creators put into their craft. As well as being inspired by the games and art you're making, I love hearing the stories of how this community experiments and innovates. So I want to congratulate all the nominees and all the winners tonight, as well as everyone in the amazing Dreams community for everything that you create. Good luck in the Dreamiverse over the next year. I just can't wait to see what you'll make next.
Thank you so much to our guest judges for Creation of the Year, Janet, Greg, and Blessing from Kinda Funny.
Oh, not again. Yes, third try. All right, this is our show now, you big meatbags. Move over.
I knew it. They've become sentient. Literally every indie horror game warned me this would happen.
It's Puppet Me. Nice haircut, bud. I didn't notice that earlier. Thank you. See how much it means when someone takes the time to say something nice? When it's not all, ooh, let's crash the Impy Awards on a giant tentacle monster. He gets me.
He is you. And they told us we could host this year. I just wanted the stage time we were promised.
Well, the show's sort of over now, kids. We just did the last award. You can help us do the outro, though.
Ooh, all right. Thanks very much for tuning into the third annual Impy Awards. The awards bit might be over, but the party continues in Dreams.
Oh, my bit. Go check out the playable Impy's Hub in-game, which features loads of tributes to even more Dreams creations and players from all across the community.
A big round of applause to all of our guest judges for being so generous with their time. Our many friends and special guests who have made glittering appearances tonight, and of course, to the team of Molecules who helped make this show happen and made us puppets. Father, where are you?
Okay, let's not go there. Last but not least, thanks to all of you at home for watching, and particularly to the Dreams community. You have given us so much to celebrate tonight.
We'll see you next year, everyone.
PlayStation.